soul ties. Mm. Explain kind of what they are. Mm-hmm. Did you both have soul ties? And yes. Is the whole world watching? Yeah. I mean, just about to have soul ties. It's going on in the church. And we talked about, it's at school. It's at, no, it's in the church.
It's in the church.
Yeah. So anytime that two people come together sexually, there is supposed to be a soul tie formed. That's how God intended it. Mm-hmm. He intended for the act of sex to be the most powerful bond that two humans can have. It's supposed to bind you in a three-banded cord, mm-hmm. emotionally, spiritually, and physically. Mm-hmm. So when we come together, there's supposed to be a connection there that's supposed to make us want to be together again and be together again. Yeah. What happens is when you form that covenant with somebody that you, when you do that act with somebody that you're not in covenant with, that you've committed your life to, what that allows you to do is form a tie with somebody who's gonna leave, mm-hmm. or form a tie with somebody who's gonna break. And I liken it to this. It's like two pieces of construction paper being super glued together, mm-hmm. and then you trying to rip those pieces of paper apart, mm-hmm. to find out that both of them are going to have pieces of whatever that other color was on each other.
That's true.
And that's what happens. And I tell people, when God recognized marriage in the Bible, it wasn't the wedding dress, it wasn't the party, it was that's when that right. husband and wife came together and consummated the marriage. And in that moment, a soul tie was formed. And I say, how many people are we married to without saying I do?